Hello, welcome to the Sound of Science, the place where we deconstruct unscientific bogus and silly scams. Let's go get them. So, one of my viewers pointed me at the Christian YouTube channel called JCO Journey, and he noted that the guy who runs the channel totally messes up the burden of proof, and I was interested to see what was going on. So, take it away, JCO Journey.
The shifting the burden of proof fallacy occurs when someone attempts to make their opponent responsible for disproving their claim rather than providing evidence for it themselves.
Sure. And that is about what shifting the burden of proof is. Unfortunately, we see Christians doing this over and over again in discussions, but for some reason, I don't think you're going to address that in your video.
This tactic is commonly used in debates and discussions to avoid the responsibility of substantiating one's own argument, effectively placing the onus on the other party to disprove a statement. The structure of shifting the burden of proof fallacy is as follows. Person A makes a claim X. Person B challenges claim X, asking for evidence. Lastly, instead of providing evidence, person A demands that person B disproves claim X.
Yeah, sure. So an example of that would be, a Christian says, my God exists. And then I ask, can you prove that? And then the Christian asks, can you prove that my God doesn't exist? Which again is a nonsensical request, but it's a classic example of shifting the burden of proof, and we see Christians do this over and over and over again.
This type of reasoning is fallacious because it inverts the logical responsibility. The person making the claim should provide evidence or reasoning, not the one questioning it. Let's examine this example. Person A asserts, ghosts exist. Person B asks, what evidence do you have to support this? Person A responds with, you can't prove they don't exist. In this example, person A is committing shifting the burden of proof fallacy. Instead of providing evidence for the existence of ghosts, person A is improperly shifting the responsibility to person B to disprove the claim.
That is actually a pretty good example, because it reflects what Christians believe. They somehow think that there is some kind of afterlife in which we will continue to exist as immaterial beings. So that is what ghosts are. Christians basically believe in ghosts. And if we ask them to prove that these ghosts and this afterlife thing exist, some of them indeed respond with, you can't prove the afterlife doesn't exist. So they are shifting the burden of proof. You could make your example even more simple. Just replace ghosts with God. That would have been an even more appropriate example, since you're a Christian who claims God exists.
Consider another example.
But we don't need another example. You've explained what shifting the burden of proof is, and you did that quite properly. And your ghost's example is just fine.
Person A states, I like to believe that God exists.
Wait a minute. I think we now need to watch very carefully what you're saying, because this example concerns a statement with a totally different structure and value than your previous example. The previous example, which was ghosts exist, was a clear-cut, unambiguous truth claim about ghosts. However, I lack the belief that a God exists is a bit of a tricky phrasing. It might look like a claim about a God, but it's not. If someone says, I lack the belief that a God exists, they don't claim anything about a God. It is a claim about the personal belief situation of the individual who makes the claim. So if we would ask this person to prove this claim, they don't have to prove anything about a God. They only need to prove that they don't believe, which is pretty hard to prove 100%, but of course, this person could produce, for example, a long history of writing and a long history of public conversations, in which this person has repeatedly stated and explained that they don't believe. So again, to make this very clear, the claim, I lack the belief that a God exists, doesn't claim anything about any God. It only says something about the person who makes the claim.
Person A states, I lack the belief that God exists. Person B responds with, what are your reasons? Person A continues, well, you can't prove God exists. Here. Person A is again shifting the burden of proof by requiring person B to prove God exists rather than presenting reasoning to support their claim.
But what you're doing now is totally different from your own definition of what shifting the burden of proof is. When you explained the principle of shifting the burden of proof, you said it worked like this. Person A makes claim X, and then person B asks for evidence to prove this claim X. And then person A says to person B, well, you can't prove that X is not true, and that indeed is what shifting the burden of proof is. Essential for this principle is that we keep addressing the same claim X throughout the process, and we need to hold on to the same line of questioning as in your own explanation. In this example that you proposed yourself, claim X is I lack belief. And then in the next step of this example, person B suddenly asks for reasons why a God doesn't exist. But person A never made a claim about a God. He made a claim about his own personal belief situation. So when person A says, I lack belief in a God, then person B should say, according to your own explanation, what evidence do you have to support that? Just like you said yourself in your ghost example. Well, then my answer would be, my evidence is that I run an entire YouTube channel on which I express my disbelief. You can find over 100 videos there where I detail my disbelief. You can study the comment section in which I posted thousands of comments in which I express my disbelief. So that is my evidence that I lack belief, which was the initial claim that you proposed yourself for this example. And that would be where this example ends, because shifting the burden of proof is no longer relevant, because I've sufficiently proven that I lack belief. Where did all of this go wrong? Well, in this example, you decided to abandon the initial claim that you proposed yourself. So while trying to demonstrate that person A shifts the burden of proof, you yourself shift the burden of proof.
Here are some strategies to counter the shifting the burden of proof fallacy. Firstly, remind the person making the claim that the burden of proof lies with them.
Sure, my claim is I lack belief, and it's up to me to prove that I lack belief. No problem.
Secondly, request specific or concrete evidence to support their claim. This puts the focus back on them to substantiate what they are saying.
Sure, as I already explained, you can watch 100 videos of mine and thousands of comments that all demonstrate that I lack belief.
Lastly, if the person continues to evade providing evidence, point out that they are attempting to shift the burden of proof, which is a logical fallacy.
Which again is totally irrelevant, because it's fairly easy for me to prove the claim that I lack belief. As it seems, the claim I lack belief is totally resistant against your strategy. Oh, sweet mother of Gandalf. Christians and the burden of proof. It has always been a problematic relationship. But while you're here, maybe subscribe to my channel, because I'm such a nice guy. I'm really much nicer than the Christian God. I won't send you into the lakes of fire. I won't drown your entire village. I'm not going to tell you what to do and what not to do. Not going to get angry when you eat some fruit. So, subscribe to the channel. Yeah, it's a good idea.